Today on the show, we talk about your summer plans, get ready for Mother's Day, and highlight some teachers that won't be back at Fort Mill next year. It's Friday, May 10th, and the buzz starts right now.
Quiet treason, and for a fortnight there, we were forever running to you. Sometimes ask about the weather. Now you're in my backyard. Turn into good neighbors. Your wife waters flowers. I wanna kill her.
Hey, Fort Mill. Welcome back to the last regular episode of The Buzz.
It's me and Bailey's last time anchoring together.
To start us off, here's Jackson with sports.
What's up, Fort Mill? I'm Jackson, and for the last time, you're watching The Buzz Sports. Our football team finished 2-9, the best record since 2017. The leading scorer was me with 5 touchdowns, and Braylon Thomas had 3 defensive turnovers. Girls volleyball ended 15-8. Tori Bowling had 229 kills, while Kendall Crossley had 54 blocks. Boys volleyball finished 14-13-2 and made the playoffs in their inaugural season. Tillman Campbell had 247 kills, while Christian Young held up the defense with 212 digs. Our boys swim team won states, and our girls swim team won states for the second year in a row. Shout out to Olivia Corby for winning an individual state championship. Boys cross country finished 2nd in the state, and Isaac Campbell won the region. Girls cross country won the state championship, and Olivia Cleveland won back-to-back individual state championships. Girls golf won the region this year and finished 12th in the state tournament. Our cheer team finished 9th in the state and did a great job supporting our teams this year. Boys basketball ended the year 17-11. A.J. Washington averaged 16.3 points per game, and Daryl Carrington finished with 13 blocks. Girls basketball finished 17-10, led by Reagan Reyes, while Izzy Barber and Julian Chambliss knocked down shots from the outside. Our wrestling team won the state championship for the second year in a row and had 6 individual state qualifiers. Tucker Gibson, Luke Van Bynum, Lincoln Green, Aiden Eubanks, Jacob Nally, and Joseph Richardson. Our boys soccer team finished 15-8-1 and won the Upper State Championship. Brayden Greitz scored 24 times this year, including 4 times in 1 playoff game. Camden Slaney led the team with 10 assists. They play in the state championship today, so you guys better be there. Our girls soccer team finished 8-11-2, and the leading scorer was Lauren Hardy with 8 goals, while Olivia Helfrich assisted 5 times. Boys lacrosse finished 7-11, and Joey Curtis led with 44 goals. Mark Newland had the most takeaways in South Carolina and the 16th most in the nation. Girls lacrosse finished 13-6, undefeated 8-0 in the region, and were the Upper State champions. Sophomore Molly Bennett led with 40 goals, and Emery Dove had the 7th highest save percentage in the state with 58.4. Boys track had 3 region champions, Joseph Dewey in javelin, Elijah Grant in the 400, and Caleb Dennis in triple jump. Girls track had 1 region champion, Marissa Jones, in the high jump. Baseball is 22-8, and they won the region this year. Carter Blankenship hit .389 on the year, and Brent Lauder had a near-perfect fielding percentage at 99.2%. Softball finished 5-13, and Brooke Rosiero hit .475, while Haley Rogers had 28 Ks. Boys tennis was a strong 5-1 this year, and they won in the first round of the playoffs. Our boys golf team plays 2nd in the region. Baker Tolentino, Mason Jackley, and Austin Anderson all made the all-region team.
This has been an amazing year of sports for Fort Mill. Every single team made the playoffs. Also, congratulations to all of our athletes who are going to be playing at the collegiate level. Now, back to the anchor desk.
Thanks, Jackson. I love going out to support our athletes.
Agreed, but the traffic can make it really difficult to get to school sometimes.
That's why we were really excited to find out that the town is working to make the commute a little easier. Here's Tanner with more.
The new interchange at Exit 85 on Highway 160 began construction a few weeks ago. To see how this affects you guys and your rides to school, we talked to an engineer involved in the project at the South Carolina Department of Transportation for more information.
So the project is expected to take until November of 2027, kind of the end of 2027 is our completion date. So about 4 full years of construction, maybe a little less. The work on 160 begins out at Pleasant, a little bit past Pleasant to tie in, past this Harris Teeter right here. Again, it'll go all the way to US 21, and then it'll start tapering back down as it approaches Fort Mill. And then on I-77, we'll build the new ramps and everything to tie in. And not a whole lot's happening to the I-77 main line. Most of the work is kind of around the interchange as well as on 160. When the project's completed, obviously 160 itself will be widened to six lanes overall, 3 lanes in each direction with turn lanes and everything. But so that is adding an additional lane all the way again from Pleasant to 21. So that alone is gonna significantly increase the throughput on SC-160. So again, Fort Mill High School back over here. So assuming you're coming from Baxter or, you know, kind of the areas over here off of Pleasant, obviously getting on 160 will be much easier to get from one side to the other as we have additional capacity to accommodate the traffic.
This is a pretty big project and hopefully it'll wrap up soon. I'm Tanner reporting for The Buzz.
Thanks, Tanner. That's really exciting, but it sounds like it won't be done for a while.
But something coming up really soon is Mother's Day. Everyone around to ask you guys about your moms.
Hey Fort Mill, since Mother's Day is this Sunday, I went around and asked you what your mom's favorite line is.
Okay, what is your most used mom line?
Well, I'm a dog mom, and so I always say, hi, how are you? I love you so much. Treats, treats, treats.
What's your mom's favorite line?
My mom's favorite line is probably, Tyson, go, you gotta go pick up your room.
That's a good one.
Yeah.
We're the kind of house that never leaves without saying I love you. So I guess it would be, I love you.
You can just tell me.
What is your mom's favorite line?
Speed limit's 55.
That's a good one. What is your most used mom line?
I don't know if it's a line, but I just like to constantly tell them that I am proud of them and that I love them every day.
I love you, Mom!
We love you, Mom!
If you need a last-minute Mother's Day present, what mom doesn't love to read?
Here's a small business to give you exactly what you need.
Liberty Book Co. is an independently owned bookstore in Rock Hill. It has a multitude of genres, a great environment, and is only a 16-minute drive from the school.
The business opened in October of 2018. We got the building in June of that year, and the decision to open this business followed the closure of another local bookstore that I worked at for about a decade. When that business closed in January of 2018, we made the decision to start this. I've always had an interest in antiques and old things, and my mother was an antique dealer when I was a child. When we were setting up the business, I wanted it to reflect not just my taste, but I wanted it to reflect the different eras and different influences that affect books and that influence writers. And so that's what guided a lot of the decisions artistically. We have, over the years, worked with the community in having a D&D and tabletop gaming here. We have a book club that meets every month, in addition to a seasonal book club that meets every 3 months. But the local author section is really important to us because, in addition to just wanting to be part of the local community as a bookstore, we also really like to nurture the interests and passions of people who do write or who have created something in book form, whether it is actually intended to be read or not. Since we do have new and used books here, we get used books from people trading them in, and it can be anything. So I have had all kinds of books get traded in over the years. Really, really old books, which always fascinates me. Rare and esoteric books on topics that just don't get a lot of traditional publishing. So seeing just what might walk in the door every day or every week is always, it's so much fun, it's interesting. It's like Christmas every day. Everybody that walks in the store has a different story and a different set of life experiences.
With this school year coming to a close, we sadly say goodbye to three of our teachers and staff, Mr. Stokes, Mr. Reeves, and Mr. Clark. Let's see what they have to say about their time at Fort Mill High School.
My favorite memory is probably getting pied in the face for charity for this past Christmas with Miss Fairchild's Club.
My favorite part with the way that we do the shows here is that, you know, every opening night, I get to sort of sit back and just watch everything that we've created over the previous couple months. And it's all student run at that point. And so it's that moment when I first get to sit down and there's just like a sigh of relief that like now the students get to take the stage and just have fun with what they've put so much time and energy in. And just seeing that curtain open for the first time for each show is probably been, you know, the best part at Fort Mill for sure.
These teachers will always be a part of the Fort Mill family, no matter what path they take. I'm Joey Corey with the Fort Mill Buzz.
It makes me sad that we won't get to see these amazing people at our school next year.
But before we have to worry about next year, we still have summer to look forward to.
Stanley asked you guys about your summer plans.
The long-awaited summer is finally almost here, and a lot of students can't wait. We went around the school to ask a couple people about what they're doing for their summer.
My name is Gavin Gordon, and I'm going to Lake Lure to spend time with my mommy and my daddy, because I don't get to see him much because of lacrosse practice and stuff. I really need it. And it's going to be relaxing, get to lay out in the lake, get a little tan going. I just can't wait. I can maybe go down and play pickleball at the pickleball courts, go rock climbing with my father.
Hi, my name is Ethan, and my summer plans are just playing sports and go to the beach.
My summer plans are to go to the beach a lot and go to California.
Hi, my name is Jack Kadish, and my plans for the summer are to go to a lot of wrestling camps and hang out with my friends on the river.
I'm going to be traveling off a remote island off the coast of Africa, and I'm going to be studying the minerals in the sand. So it's going to be a lot of fun traveling with my dad. So excited to spend some quality time with him.
My summer plans are hanging out with the friends and playing lacrosse.
I'm going to be going to Lake Lure with Gavin's mommy and daddy. We're going to go tubing.
Sounds like Fort Mill students are going to have a lot of fun this summer. Reporting for The Buzz, I'm Stanley.
Well, it may not be the end of the year, but it is the end of our show.
Get excited because next week is Junior Takeover and the following week is the JV Buzz.
Have a happy Friday, Fort Mill.
It's me and Bailey's last time anchoring together. Yes! We'll be done for... What was I even going to say?
I don't know.
I've tried to freestyle before. It did not go well.
Did you take a video?
No, there's no video evidence anywhere of me trying to freestyle. What mom doesn't love to read?
If you need a new gift. All right.
Okay, we're not putting me rapping in the bloopers, okay?
Yeah, we should.
No, we're not. That dies okay. With us. What mom doesn't love to read?
She's a small business.
It's so funny because when you mess up, you like visibly shrink. You want to wrap it?
Read, need. I don't know.